Hello everyone, welcome to the series of C tutorials. In this presentation, we will be concentrating on basic syntax and control flow of a program. This is our very first program to print the text hello world. First, we included the header file, the standard input-output library. In the main function, we are using function called printf and we are passing array of characters as arguments. To compile the program, type in the command in virtual terminal gcc space name of the program with an extension .c, then finally print the output by running the machine executable code. Data types. There are six primitive data types in C language. Those are character. Generally, it is 1 byte. Integer. Integer is generally 4 bytes. This entirely depends on what compiler we are using and it is dependent on the hardware we are using. Generally short is 2 byte integer. Long is 8 bytes. Float is 4 bytes. And double is 8 bytes floating point number. Generally these all are signed data types. We can use unsigned qualifier as well. Control flow. Statements. A series of expressions with a terminating semicolon constitutes a statement. Here we can see two statements. We are initializing a value to a variable, that is also a statement, and we are using printf function, that could also be considered as a statement. Logical if else statements. If the condition in if statements turns out to be true or 1, the if block will be executed, or else the else block will be executed. Whatever the statements we write in if the condition is true, these statements will be executed, else the else block will be executed. This is a simple program to demonstrate if else statement. In the main function, we defined a variable named age and we initialized to 23. In the if else statement, we are checking the condition. If age is less than 18, print cannot vote, or else print go vote. Since 23 is greater than 18, the if statement is discarded. The else block will be executed. The output will be go vote. Else if statements. We can branch multiple if statements in if else conditions. If condition 1 turns out to be false, else if condition will be checked. If the condition of else if condition 2 turns out to be false, the next else if condition is checked, that is condition 3, so on and so forth. Finally, we can write else statement, or we may not, that is optional. This is a simple program to demonstrate else if statements. In the main function, we defined a variable named findMe of type integer and we initialized value to 29. Here we are checking if findMe is greater than or equal to 0 and findMe is less than or equal to 10, print this statement, or else if findMe is greater than or equal to 11 and findMe is less than or equal to 20, print this. There are multiple else if statements. Finally, there is an else statement. The value of findMe is 29. So the third if statement, or the second else if statement, is executed. Since 29 is greater than 21 and 29 is less than 30, so the second else if statement is executed. Switch. Switch is similar to if statements, where statements are executed on case value. Point to remember, switch is not a complete replacement for if statements. The syntax of switch case as follows. Switch, within the parentheses, we will write a value or expression. And this value or expression are compared against the case values. If the compared case value matches the value or expression, that block of statement will be executed. If break is not used, the execution sequence will continue. We can have default statement where if none of the cases turns out to be true, the default statement will be executed. Default statement is optional and break is also optional. It is better to write break for each case values and default as well, depending on the problem statement. This is a simple example to demonstrate the switch case. In the main function, we defined three variables, A, B, and option. And we are getting the value from user. In order to achieve that, use scanf function to get input from the user. We are passing the address of option A and B. In the switch case, we are checking the option. User can input 1, 2, or 3. 1 is for add, 2 is for subtract, 3 is for multiply. If the option value is 1, the case 1 will be executed. These statements will be executed. If the option value is 2, this case 2 will be executed. If the option value is 3, the case 3. These two statements will be executed. If user inputs some other value apart from 1, 2 or 3, the default case will be executed. The default statements will be executed. Here you can see the output. User gave an option 1 and the value of variable A is 2 and value of variable B is 3. We are adding those two values. Loops repeats block of statements until the condition becomes false or zero. The syntax to write for statement is as follows. We have three compartments in the for statement. The first one is initial values, where we type in the initial values for the for block and we will check the condition. If the condition is true, we can change the values of the initial values within the curly brackets, right in the commands. This is a simple program to demonstrate the for loop. In the main function, we defined a variable I without initializing any value. For I is equal to 1, the I value becomes 1, the initial value. Now check the condition. If I is less than it, 1 is less than it, that is true. Print the statement or just execute the block of codes. In this case, we wrote printf function. We are printing the value I here. Hello day space, the format specifier integer, where the value of I will be replaced in here. Once the statements are executed, change the values. Here we are incrementing the value of I. This loop will continue until the condition becomes false, until the value of I becomes 8 in this case. This is the output we can see at the bottom. Infinite loop. We can use for loop for infinite looping. In the main function, we just wrote for without giving any initial value, nor the condition, nor any change of values. This program will continue infinitely. While statements repeats block of statements until the condition becomes false. While can accept either the logical true or logical false. While statement will execute if the condition becomes true. Once the condition becomes false, it will come out of the loop. This is the syntax to write the while loops. While, within the parentheses, write the conditions. If the condition turns out to be true, the statements will be executed. If condition is false, exit the loop. This is a simple program to demonstrate while loop. In the main function, we defined a variable named j and we initialized the value 5. In the while statement, the condition is while j is greater than 0, print the statements or execute the block of statements. In this case, we are printing the count value, that is the value of j. In the next statement, we are decrementing the value of j. Initially j is 5, now j is 4. Is 4 is greater than 0? Yes. Execute the block of statements. Now decrement the value of j. Now j becomes 3, so on and so forth until the value of j becomes 0. We can see the output at the bottom of the screen. Do while statements repeats block of statement or statements until condition becomes false in the while part. The difference between while loop and do while loop is do while loop executes at least one time. Doesn't matter what the condition we mentioned in the while loop. Do while loop will execute at least once. Then it will check the condition. Then it will behave as the while loop. This is a simple program to demonstrate do while loop. In the main function, we defined a variable named I. Here we can notice that the value of I is 7. 7 is not equal to 0. The condition is false. Even though the condition is false, do while loop executed once. Here we can see the output. Hey there, I am printing. Hey there, I am printing. That is what we mentioned in the do block. Break. Break keyword is used to terminate a loop and continue with the rest of the process. If there exist multiple inner loops, we have to use multiple breaks to get out of that particular loop. We have to be careful while writing break statements. Break can only break a given loop. This is a simple program to demonstrate the usage of break. In the main function, we defined a variable named I. In the for loop, we are writing initial value for I. I is equal to 0. Next, we are checking the condition. I is less than 5. Yes, 0 is less than 5. Go into the block of statements. Now check if I is equal to 3. Break. Since the value of I is 0, the if statement will not be executed. We will print the value of I. Here we can see the output down there, 0. Now increment the value of I. Now the value of I is 1. 1 is less than 5. Yes. Now we are checking if 1 is equal to 3. No. Don't execute the if statement. Print the value of I. That is 1. Then increment the value of I. I becomes 2. 2 is not equal to 3. Discard. Print the value of I 2. Now increment the value of 3. If I is equal to 3, yes, the condition is true. Break the for loop. This program prints the number from 0 to 2. Continue keyword skips an iteration within a given loop and continues rest of the process until the loop condition is false. The difference between the break statement and a continue statement is that break statement breaks the entire loop, whereas the continue statement just skips the present iteration. This is a simple program to demonstrate the working of continue. In the main function, we defined a variable named I and we defined a for loop such as I is equal to 0, the value of I is 0, I is less than 5, 0 is less than 5. Get into the for statements. Now again check if 0 is equal to 3. Now the condition is false. Skip the if statement, then print the value of I. Next, we are incrementing the value of I. the value becomes 1, 1 is less than 5, 1 is not equal to 3, print the value of I, increment the value of I. Now the I becomes 2, 2 less than 5, is 2 equal to 3? No, print the value of I, increment I becomes 3, 3 is less than 5, yes, the condition is true. Check the condition if 3 is equal to 3. Yes, the condition is true. Continue. The print statement will not be executed since we are skipping the iteration by using the keyword continue. Here you can see the output. The value 3 is skipped and we have the value 4. That is the next iteration. Go to and label. Go to keyword transfers the ongoing process to the label where we defined in the program. If goto is encountered within the nested loop, all loops will be terminated. It is better to use goto sparingly since it may result in some unexpected problems.